Singapore, Japan, Thailand, Hong Kong, Germany, France, Vietnam, South Korea, and Australia. We can already see that local transmission is happening in other countries. These developments are compelling reasons to prepare mitigation mechanisms for the possibility of community spread. We are continuously assessing the situation and crafting our own guidelines based on available evidence to combat the threat of the COVID-19. We'd like to give you updates on our repatriates, the ones who are under quarantine at the New Clark City. Yesterday, two repatriates, a one-year-old male and a 34-year-old female, were brought to the Jose Bilingad Memorial General Hospital due to diarrhea and abdominal discomfort. So, may dalawa tayong dinala, no? Kasi sumakit yung tiyan nila. However, both tested negative for the 2019 and COVID, and they will be sent back to the New Clark City to complete their 14-day quarantine period, no? So, negative sila for the 2019 and COVID. We are checking on our repatriates twice a day to ensure that they are properly being cared for. And we will be providing them with SIM and cell cards for those who don't have mobile access within the facility so that they can contact their families. Daily activities are organized to keep them busy and lessen the boredom. And we are likewise facilitating psychosocial processing to ensure their mental well-being while they are there in quarantine. For our patients under investigation, as of 12 noon today, there are now 238 PUI cases currently admitted in various health facilities all over the country, while 162 PUIs have already been discharged. Meanwhile, 208 PUIs have already tested negative. Yung mga iba for discharge na rin yan, no, once wala na silang sakit. And that number of the three that have tested positive for the novel coronavirus has not increased. So until now, we only have our three imported cases as positive for the 2019 and COVID, and 208 have tested negative. There are 197 cases pending test results from RITM right now. So there are another 197 samples that are lined up at RITM for testing. For our contact tracing, as of February 12, the Epidemiology Bureau, together with the PNPCIDG, has identified all 455 contacts of the first and second cases of COVID-19. Of the 455 contacts, 277 have been interviewed and 44 contacts found to be symptomatic and have been admitted as persons under investigation. So yung first two cases natin, yung couple, meron tayo ngayong 44 na merong symptoms and are admitted as PUIs. On the third case, yung last na natin na-report na case, a total of 246 out of 731 contacts were traced. So yung number ng contacts natin that are being traced has increased to 731 because the Epidemiology Bureau decided to include all passengers na kasabay doon sa fast craft from Cebu to Tagbilaran. No? Wala kasing seating arrangement yun. No? So lahat talaga ng sumakay yun sa buong manifesto are being traced. This include co-passengers and individual contacts from hotels and hospitals. Currently, 164 of them have been interviewed, of which 149 are on home quarantine and 15 had symptoms and have been categorized as PUIs and admitted for isolation and monitoring. So wala na rin tayo ng mga nagre-refuse ng admission and isolation. All of them have agreed naman na already to admission once classified as a PUI. Thank you.
Okay, let's now entertain questions.
Yung cumulative number of PUIs natin to date is 382. Ay, sorry, mali pala dating na yung table sa baba. 408, I'm sorry, 408. February 12, February 11 yung 382.
Sir, follow-up lang. 238 admitted, tapos
165 discharged.
Not 162 as earlier announced.
165. 238 admitted, 165 discharged. We have the two mortalities. And then, two mortality, two discharge din tayo na mga confirmed and one mortality na confirmed, which makes a total of 408.
Copy, sir. Sir, about dun sa total number of PUIs natin, may we know ilan dito yung mga health workers na nag-care dun sa tatlong positive cases natin? And kamusta na po yung situation nila? And also, sir, have there been any effort from the DOH to somehow boost the safety measures being observed by our health workers para hindi sila makaout dun sa PUIs natin?
Yeah, well, I do not have the numbers of the health workers here. No? All I know is that 59% of them are Filipinos, 240, and that includes some health workers. But there are very few health workers, especially in the first two cases natin. No? But since then, we've been more strict with our personal protective equipment and of course, yung infection control natin. And yung hospitals naman natin pinoprovide ng gamit ng ano, no, to the regional offices ng DOH for the PPEs.
Janelle?
Doc Rabi mentioned yesterday that RITM was provided with reagents for at least 1,500 tests. So RITM is still doing all of the tests, right? But yes. You said, I think last week or earlier this week, that it is a directive of the president to, you know, expand the testing. Or is the DOH already training or looking at other laboratories that are capable?
Yeah, RITM is trying to develop. We have reached sub-national reference labs. We have in Davao, in Cebu, and two others. Dito rin sa San Lazaro meron. So RITM is working on that, the training and of course yung proficiency, just to check. And we're also waiting for some private hospitals to submit themselves to accreditation, to apply for accreditation. Kasi some hospitals have signified their intention na na-complete naman daw sila ng PCR capability and that they have trained personnel. So once they go to RITM for accreditation, it's a check lang naman. Just to make sure that all test results that will come out of these labs are valid.
Okay, so RITM has sub-national reference labs, so four?
The Department of Health, yeah, has four.
Four, okay. Tapos, can you mention which hospitals have...
Well, I know we have one in the Southern Philippines Medical Center. Meron tayo sa Vicente Soto, San Lazaro yung isa, San Lazaro and Baguio. Yeah, Baguio General Hospital.
My last question would be about the rapid test kits. Actually, you just talked to Dr. Rabi, and he said he didn't say anything about the rapid test kits. He said that WHO is helping with the laboratory capacity. So there is no longer talk about
rapid tests? No, the rapid test kits, from the last, update we have from WHO, is that they are trying to validate at least one rapid test kit that's being marketed in the, out there. But they told us 1 to 2 weeks talaga before they can validate it. And it's only a week. So hopefully by next week, they would have at least one rapid test kit validated that we will be able to use.
Yung 1,500, yung reagents for at least 1,500 tests, how long will that last RITM, you think?
Well, at the rate we're going right now, no, we have, siguro we get about 100, anywhere from 80 to 100 specimen a day. So that would last maybe 2 weeks, 2 to 3 weeks, including yung natira from the first batch.
You said regarding po dun sa dalawang nakitaan ng symptoms sa New Clark City, yung profile po nila, and then yung protocol when it comes to that. For example, nakitaan ng symptoms, ilalabas po sa health facility, then after tested na negative siya, ibabalik po doon.
Yes, ito kasi yung unusual yung symptom niya. I think we've all read that aside from the usual fever, cough, and difficulty in breathing, one symptom that a more unusual symptom is diarrhea. So in this case, walang cough and fever tong two repatriates natin, but they had diarrhea, so they were brought to JB Lingad for assessment kung persons under investigation sila. Pero since the test came out negative, na alam naman natin negative sila, they're still returned to the New Clark City to complete the 14-day quarantine period para make sure lang tayo na yung incubation period makompleto natin. Kasi in pwedeng negative siya ngayon, pero ilang araw pa lang sila, 3 days pa lang sila, di ba? So we want to complete the 10 days. So that's the... Unless talagang makita na PUI siya and then possible talaga na NCOV siya, then they stay in the hospital. In this case, kasi negative siya.
And para malinaw lang po sa publiko, nagtatanong po sila, within the stay po doon sa loob ng NCC during quarantine period, ano po yung like daily activities, paano po yung monitoring ng mga health staff sa mga repatriates?
Yung monitoring natin is done twice a day, no? In the morning and the afternoon, check the vital signs, temperature, and check for any ano no, for any signs and symptoms. And yun nga, we are trying to organize activities for them kasi it can get very boring, no, for 14 days na nakakulong. And we try to find activities for them. But I don't have that schedule that they have daily right now.
Thank you. Sir Rafi, TV5, Sir Jovic, and Ma'am Gina.
Perfecto lang. Yung ano ba, yung 1-year-old and 34-year-old, are they related? Kasi it seems that they both have diarrhea.
From my reports, ang tingin ko they are related. Kasi may sumama pa na, may parang family sila. So sumama din yung ibang family actually when they went to the hospital together.
Okay. Sir, when it comes to the travel restrictions in Taiwan, kasi sinabi po ni Secretary Panelo yesterday that they will be waiting for the recommendation of the WHO, but then here comes WHO saying that they never recommended any travel restrictions. It's up to the countries to decide independently. Do you still see the need that, given the decrease now in numbers, do you still see the need to impose these travel restrictions?
Oh, I cannot comment on that. The Interagency Task Force, I think, has assigned a communications person for that. So anything that has to do with that will have to come from the IATF.
Pero sir, WHO, they are not recommending.
The WHO has never recommended any travel restrictions up to date. But they respect each and every country's sovereignty and yung decision ng each and every country.
But how fluid is the decision making in terms of imposing the travel restrictions? Can we say that now we're imposing it and then suddenly tomorrow it can be lifted?
No, I think the IATF is meeting regularly and reassessing the situation regularly. The Interagency Task Force, I think they will come up with an announcement maybe tomorrow or Friday.
Sir, is there a possibility po na ma-extend to 24 days yung quarantine period following reports ka na 24 days daw yung incubation period?
No. Yung report na yon says that the incubation period is anywhere from 3 days to 24 days. But kasi laging may outliers di ba? In any disease. But you know that yung middle niyan, 99% of cases will probably fall between 7 days and 14 days and 12 days. So yung 14 days medyo mahaba na yon. Even the WHO is not recommending extending it beyond 14 days.
Sir Jovi?
Sir, yung sa timeline lang dun sa NCC, kasi to my understanding, yung test natin na ginagawa to determine if negative is 48 hours yung turnaround time. Yeah. Bakit mabilis yung lumabas yung results dito?
Yung actual testing is only 24 hours, no? Less than 24 hours yan. Yung turnaround time kasi includes transport and then bringing it there. Pero syempre, pag ganito na mas urgent, pwede na kasi may pila eh. So I guess for these cases, since there was a little urgency, they decided to put them ahead and that's why we got the results earlier. So yung 48 hours is maximum pag dumating sa RITM dun sa pila.
Dalawang negative test na to, sir, or isa pa lang?
Tig-isang negative test, oh.
Tapos may mga research din kasi, sir, na lumalabas na yung pangolin daw ang possible na source of the virus. Yeah, meron ba tayong efforts to corroborate?
Well, WHO is the one investigating this together with the government of China. But until now, there's nothing, there's no hard evidence. Parang yun lang ang direction ng investigation right now. But there's no evidence yet for that.
Sir, may information kayo, yung mga Pilipinos sa world who are considered PUIs and confirmed cases? Pilipinos abroad na PUIs and confirmed. May data kayo?
Well, ang dire-report lang nat sa atin kasi yung mga crew members nung nando sa ship, di ba? And then I think we have another one in the Middle East who is stable. Pero yung mga nandun din sa cruise ship natin na mga crew members, stable din naman and they are being taken care of in Japan.
Sir, total sir, ilan yung Pilipinos abroad na PUIs and ilan yung confirmed?
Oh, I'm sorry, it's not in my report ngayon. We have to get that from the international health regulations.
Sir, sino yung leading agency do sa task force? Yung international, yung agency.
Interagency task force, the Department of Health.
Magsasalita?
I hindi ako member nung task force. I think they're designating a communications person for it.
For the meantime, sir, sino pwede namin tanungin for updates?
The Secretary of Health, I would guess.
I'm Trish.
Sir, there are reports, although unconfirmed, na airborne daw itong NCOV. But then, even though it's unconfirmed, we're trying to mitigate, from what I understand, yung, we're trying to mitigate yung local transmission in the country. So, considering that, sir, na may reports na airborne, are we now, what are we doing in terms of ramping up efforts para maiwasan to? Magbabago ba tayo ng advisory in terms of mask usage? Kasi kung airborne siya, would there be a need for everybody to wear masks already?
Well, right now that there's no hard evidence to say that it is airborne, that it can float around with the dust, we have not changed our advisory on the using of masks. No? We still only advise it for people who are sick to wear it so that you don't contaminate anybody else, for people who are immunocompromised or weak, for people who are taking care of sick people, of course, no? And for people who cannot avoid being in very, very crowded places, no? Especially kung yung crowd, hindi naman natin alam lahat kung saan ang galing. Of course, the DOH has an advisory also na to avoid yung crowded places, including crowded events, kung pwede. So, but so far, we have not changed our advisory on the use of masks.
But sir, theoretical lang naman, just in case it's proven that it's airborne, wouldn't it be too late kung kailan lang ma-announce then magbabago ng advisory on the usage of masks or other updates in terms of mitigating yung...
Yeah, but you know, we have to balance it kasi you know, we also have very limited supplies of masks now, no? So unless we have very clear evidence that it is needed, we would rather conserve, no, yung supplies natin ng masks for those who really need it. And these are the sick people, the immunocompromised.
Sir, yun dun sa first case, do we have information kung nakalabas na po siya ng bansa?
Oh, hindi. Well, alam ko lang nakalabas na siya ng ospital nung weekend. I do not have a report if the patient has already left and returned to her country.
Yung sa disposal, sir, nung body nung third case?
Wala pa rin kaming update.
Wala pa.
Yeah. Yung negative.
Another PUI, yeah.
Yeah, PUI. The third case, PUI.
Second PUI test.
Yeah, we'll have to get information on that.
Thank you.
Ma'am, sir.
Pero negative yun, hindi NCOV yun. No?
Sir, since may local transmission na sa ibang bansa, yung iba, kalapit bansa lang natin, is yung local transmission po ba dito sa Pilipinas, is it something inevitable?
Well, you know, the WHO has signified that, you know, we should all get ready because they've been seeing it happen in several countries, including countries na medyo malayo, no, na mukhang talagang very isolated, very far from China without much traffic. And they feel that all countries must prepare for the possibility that maybe eventually you're going to have local transmission. So we always have that at the back of our minds, that it will happen, that it can happen. That's why we're preparing our hospitals to make sure that kung dumami talaga yung cases and we might have to change strategies, dapat ready tayo.
Sir General.
Sir, yung sa contact tracing lang, sir. Sir, napansin lang na ano, hindi pa siya kompleto yung contact tracing. Ano pong dahilan? Bakit medyo matagal makompleto yung pag-contact dun sa mga...
Yung ang pinakamalaking dahilan, pag nasa manifesto, minsan mali yung cellphone number nila or binibigay nila na email address, no? So sa mga ganitong sitwasyon, nagpapatulong na kami sa police para hanapin sila. Yung dun sa huling case naman natin, kaya medyo marami pa kasi nga, nung una na-decide, inisip muna yung mga nakaupo muna kasama niya dun sa Fastcraft papuntang Tagbilaran, kaya lang na-realize natin na baka hindi rin naman accurate yung seating kasi sa doon sa ano sa lancha, kaya sinama na lahat. Kaya ito yung hinahabol natin ngayon na tinetrace. Pero ang pinakamahirap talaga pag hindi complete yung information. Kaya ito yung hinihiling natin sa publiko, pagsasakay ng eroplano, sasakay sana ng barko, ibigay po nyo yung tama na pangalan ninyo, tamang address ninyo, tamang cellphone number nyo, tsaka email address. Kasi hindi natin alam kung kailan siya kakailanganin.
Sir, follow-up lang. Sir, kamusta? Ano po yung assessment nyo dun sa ano na yun, may 44 na considered na POI dun sa first two cases and then dun sa third case, eh, meron naman pong 15. Ano lang po assessment nyo?
Well, kasi talagang in 2 weeks naman, ano, kapag ang isang tao, the likelihood naman na magkakaroon ka ng some sort of illness, kakaroon ka ng konting ubo, sipon, or lagnat, hindi naman kasi natin masabi na dahil sa NCOV yun, no? Pero, nag-iingat lang tayo. Kaya, sinisigurado lang natin. So far, wala pa namang nagtetest na positive sa kanila. May mga pending. Pero, bilang pag-iingat, gusto lang natin siguraduhin na lahat ng merong symptoms, eh, ma-check natin at ma-test natin.
Yusek, wala naman po dun sa currently symptomatic PUIs. Wala namang merong severe symptoms?
Wala. So far, all of our cases have mild illness. Talagang konting lagnat, ubo ang most common. But no severe illness.
Sir Jovic, Ma'am Sheila, then two last questions.
Sir, na-mention nyo kanina na Singapore and Thailand may reported local transmission cases. Are we inclined to impose a similar travel ban? Kasi like Taiwan has 18 confirmed cases as of yesterday and Singapore, I believe, nasa 40 plus.
I think yung IATF ang magano na. When they meet regularly, they discuss this and they come up naman with the guidelines for us to implement. I do not know where the discussion is going there right now because I did not attend the IATF meeting. No? But I think the assurance is that they will continue monitoring and evaluating.
Can you walk us through lang, sir, dun sa pag-add dun sa Taiwan sa travel ban, apart sa One China policy? Ano pa
I think the IATF is at liberty to talk about that, not me.
Ma'am Sheila, then, ma'am, for the last question.
Sir,
and Aika for the last question.
How prepared are we for local transmission percentage?
Ready naman tayo kasi yung mga hospitals. Kasi pag nagkaroon ng, kung makita po nyo yung example ng Singapore, no? Yung mga countries, usually, pag nagkaroon ng local transmission, nag-change kasi completely yung strategy. Saan kasi ngayon, ang gusto natin, containment, di ba? Yung hindi siya kumalat sa public. So, ginagawa natin lahat, for example, ng may sipon pa lang, may lagnat, tapos may contact, ina-admit na natin yan, tapos tinetest na natin. Kapag ang bansa, nagkaroon na ng local transmission, katulad ng Singapore, nag-shift na sila. Ang mga tao, kung ikaw meron ka kahit na NCOV ka pero mild lang, sa bahay ka na lang, ang ina-admit na lang yung mga severe cases. Tapos hindi na lahat tinetest. Ano? Pinipili mo na lang, tinetest mo na lang yung talagang high risk. So nag-change siya. No? So we are ready in the sense that we have the hospital system, that we have this isolation rooms. Right now, puno sila kasi tinatanggap pa natin, ina-admit natin at ina-isolate natin yung mga persons under investigation pa lang. Sir. Pag lumawak siya at dumami ang may sakit, nagbabago kasi talaga yan. Nagbabago din ang indications mo for admission.
Sir, yung supplies ng mask, hanggang kailan na lang tatagal?
Yung supplies ng mask, tinutulungan tayo ng DTI, no? And I think they already got the first batch of... meron supplier kasi na isa sa Bataan na actually exporter siya, pero pumayag siya na mag-supply sa Pilipinas. I think they order about 1.5 million every month. Nag-start na silang mag-deliver. So as of now, meron pa naman tayong supply ng ating mga PPEs for our health workers. Siguro mga 1 to 2 months, kaya naman natin pa. No? Kaya lang kailangan na nating magbumili talaga.
Sir, magkanong budget for PPEs?
Ito yung 2 billion na hinihingi natin sa Kongreso na supplemental budget.
Sir, ano development? Ma-approve ba? Kailan?
I'm sorry, hindi ko alam kung nasaan. Pero ang pangako naman sa atin ng mga leadership ng House Committee sa Kongreso at sa Senado is that they will prioritize it. And of course, we have the support of the President on that.
Next question, then last question, Ma'am Aiko.
Sir, nung isang araw nasa 314 yung PUIs and then today nasa 408, bakit po tumaas, sir?
Yun talagang pinakamaraming tumaas yun sa case number 3 natin. Mm-hmm. Yung sa barko. Kasi nung una, ang dami palang nakasakay doon sa kasabay niya. No? So yun yung mga tinitrace natin ngayon. And of course, yung contact tracing natin for the first and second case.
Okay. Sir, yung paparecap ko lang, sir, kung ano na po yung mga medical facilities na may available NCOV testing aside from RITM?
RITM lang.
RITM lang, sir.
Yes.
Ms. Aiko, for the last question.
Sir, clarification lang kasi mayroon pong infographic from DALG na mayroon categorized as mandatory and voluntary quarantine. Nakalagay po doon mandatory quarantine for countries, for passengers coming from China, Hong Kong, and Macau. Tapos sir, ang clarification lang po dito ng mga netizen na nagpo-post is that, for example, wala naman silang symptoms. So are they still quarantine, or I mean obliged to be quarantined po, sir? Or di ba home quarantine? Yeah. Home quarantine?
Quarantine means hospital quarantine or home quarantine. So yung mga returning Filipinos, kasi po tatanggap naman tayo ng Filipino, di ba, and permanent residents in the country. So when they get here, for example, galing silang Macau, tapos tiningnan sila ng quarantine officer natin, kung may sakit siya, ang quarantine niya sa ospital, admit siya as PUI. Pero kung wala siyang sakit, then home quarantine siya. Tapos i-monitor lang siya for the next 14 days, tatawagan, i-check. And we're working with the LGU para nga tulungan tayo hanggang doon sa barangay para ma-check lang na talaga naka-home quarantine siya.
Sir, you said na yung 15 before is hindi na sila, I mean nasa mga health facilities na sila dahil nag-refuse sila. Pero ngayon, sir, wala na po nagre-refuse na
Sa ngayon, wala na tayong nakalista na refused admission. Yung mga PUIs natin na na-contact have been admitted.
Okay, very last question. Ma'am Sheila.
Okay, well, ang Filipinos na out of the 408, no, 240 are Filipinos, 98 are Chinese, meron tayong 18 na American, meron tayong 4 from Finland, 3 na German, and then 1 each from Brazil, Britain, France, India, Italy, Japan, Korea, New Zealand, Dutch, and yung latest natin is Taiwanese. With the history, oh, kung PUI siya, dapat may history of travel to China within the last 14 days. Hindi lahat, pero within 14 days. If you have a history of travel to China within 14 days, hindi siyang kailangan yung last travel mo. Pwede siyang before ka pumunta dumaan somewhere, nanggaling ka ng China. Basta travel within the last 14 days.
The foreigners are all tourists, sir?
I hindi nakalista eh, pero presumably. No. Okay, thank
okay,
you.
Thank you very
See
much.
You on Friday.
Tomorrow.
Friday. Okay, so we'll be having our regular briefing on Friday.
At yan po ang naging pulong balitaan ng Department of Health kaugnay sa COVID-19. Kanina po ay nabanggit ni USEC Eric Domingo ng Department of Health na 238 na person under investigation dito sa Pilipinas kaugnay sa COVID-19 ay admitted. At 165 dito ang na-discharge na. Umaasa naman ng DOH na sa susunod na linggo ay mababalidate na daw ang rapid test kits ng World Health Organization o WHO. Samantala, ang monitoring sa mga repatriated Pinoys ay 2 beses daw ginagawa kada araw. Muli namang paalala ng DOH na umiwas na lamang sa mga matataong lugar at tamang paggamit ng face mask. Dahil hanggang ngayon, hindi pa rin daw malinaw ang ebidensya na pwedeng airborne ang transmission ng NCOV. Pero maghahanda pa rin daw ang lokal na pamahalaan sa posibilidad ng local transmission ng naturang sakit. At yan po ang ating live coverage. Tutok lang dito sa GMA News TV para oras-oras. Alam mo, ako po si Lala Roque. Magandang hapon.